Hi there, thank you for checking out my channel. Thank you for clicking on this video. This video is part of the series of videos I post to try to help people out when it comes to aptitude tests, like the civil service exam, UCAT, LIFELTS, and all of those things. Today we're going to talk about another math video. I know it's not Monday right now, pero I wanted to post as much of these as possible para gumag exam kayong lahat, so inahawal ko ito. And this video lesson in particular, I feel is really important for you guys, especially if you're taking an aptitude test really soon, like the civil service nitong August 12, 2018. And so today we're going to talk about a lesson na kind of part pa rin ng series natin sa ratios, and I really recommend that you watch my other ratio problem videos. Pero today we're going to talk about inverse proportions. Kailangan natin ito pag-usapan kasi you need to know the difference between direct and inverse proportions and what to do kapag yun ang hinahanap sa isang problem. In order for me to show you how to solve this type of problem, I'm going to switch over to my PC so I can show you better. I'll see you in a bit. Alright, let's talk about inverse proportions. Now, before we already talked about yung direct proportion, I discussed that in my video ratio rotation before in a bunch of the ratio word problems na na-discuss ko. If you attended one of the live review events or if you're part of the online review program, this will come really easy to you. Ito yung tapat dapat na sinasabi natin. Now, kailan pumapasok yung inverse proportions? You will start to deal with this type of problem if sa word problems na didideal ninyo, ang hinihingi niya is not a direct proportion, kundi yung inverse proportion na tinatawag. So, ang goal natin today is for you to be able to understand kung aning klaseng proportion siya, if it's a direct or an inverse proportion, and of course, kung paano siya isosolve. Now, if you haven't seen the video on ratio rotation yet, go ahead and click right here dito sa taas sa I button. Kasi yun yung pinaka-fundamental natin for this. I'm going to use the technique in this video. So, i-pause nyo muna to kung hindi nyo pa napapanood, watch that, and then come back here na lang. Okay? We're not going to use cross-multiplication kasi actually, I feel na it kind of complicates things. So, we're going to use the same technique for this. Meron lang a few minor changes. Okay? So first na goal natin, do you know ba talaga kung ang isang problem it requires direct proportion or inverse proportion na formula? Now, paano natin ito malalaman? Dito papasok yung analysis. You really have to understand the question. Okay, let me give you an example. In this question right here, it says, if 9 people can build 15 houses, how many houses can 12 people build? Now, in this case, again, if you were part of the live review program or the online review program, this will come really easy to you. You would know na ang rule lang dito is tapat-dapat. So, if you're part of, like I said, the online or the live review program, madali na to, tapat-dapat lang tayo dito. So, you have 9 people, tapos 12 people. So, here, 9 people, ito yung people side, dito 12 people. Now, itatapat lang natin. Sabi natin yung 9 people, they can build 15 houses. So, dito, ito yung houses side. You have 15 houses here. Okay? And then here, dahil nawawala yung dami ng houses na mabibuild ng 12 people, dito natin ilalagay yung X. So, X number ng houses. And then, all we need to do is just to do ratio rotation. Now, in this case, hindi masyadong madali yung 15 divided by 9 tsaka 12 divided by 9. But, you can reduce this in lowest terms pa. I-divide natin siya pareho sa 3. Okay, so that would leave us with 3 over, and then you have 4. And then here, you can start rotating na. So, 15 divided by 3 times 4. We just used ratio rotation. Ang sagot is 20. So, the answer is 20 houses. That is in this particular problem. Now, bakit itong direct na tapat dapat ang ginamit natin dito? Kasi, if you notice, again, understand the question ha. Kung ang siyam na people, 15 houses lang kaya nilang itayo, syempre, kung magdadagdag ako ng people, syempre, madadagdagan din yung dami ng houses na itatayo nila. Tama? So, 9 people, 15 houses. 12 people, 20 houses. It makes sense na dumadami siya dahil dumami yung taong gumagawa. Di ba, for example, kung ikaw, mag-isa kang gumagawa, iba yung magagawa mo. Kung may tutulong sa'yo, mas marami kayong matatapos sa loob ng isang araw. Okay? So, in this one, this is what we call the direct proportion. Pag dumami yung isa, dadami din yung isa. Pag kumonti yung isa, kukonti din yung isa. Okay? Now, kailan papasok yung inverse proportion? Let me give you this problem. We have the same numbers here, right? Sabi, if 9 people can take 15 days to build a house, how many days do 12 people need to build one? Now, bakit ito kakaiba? Kasi if you notice, ang pinag-uusapan na dito is days or oras. Gaano katagal nilang itatayo ang isang bahay? So, kung 9 people daw take 15 days, ilang araw ang kailangan ng 12 people? Now, if you put here, same thing lang, 9 people,
and then 12 people here. If I use direct proportion, again, kung hindi ko babaguhin yung structure, ang kakalabasan ay 20 days, right? Kasi 15 days, 20 days. However, that doesn't make sense. Bakit? Kasi kung siyam kayong tao and it takes you 15 days, pag dumami ang tao na nagtulungan na magtayo ng bahay, will it take them more time or less time? Now, the answer there would be less time. Tama? Bakit less time? Kasi, okay, kung magtutulong-tulong kayo, mas bibilis kayo. At kung bibilis kayo, syempre, yung dating 15 days yung tinayo, dapat less than 15 na dapat ngayon. Okay? Doon napapasok yung analysis. Now, anong mangyayari doon sa formula natin? Kanina, dito sa first one, pag direct proportion, that is tapat-dapat. Right? Paano naman kung inverse proportion? Or kung, kunyari, madami to, dapat kukonti yung kalalabasan. Simple lang ang gagawin natin. Kapag inverse proportion, parang inverse or reverse, babaliktarin natin yung pagkakatapat niya. So in this case, hindi na 9 ang katapat ng 15, itatapat natin siya sa 12. So dito natin lalagay yung 15 days. And then this will become your x. Again, anong pagkakaiwi niya dito sa direct proportion? In this case, tapat-dapat yung people sa 15 houses. Dito, yung 9 people, ang katapat niya, yung x, ibababa mo yung 15 days dito sa kabila. And then that's the time that you're going to solve. And same thing lang yung gagawin natin. So again, reduce the lowest terms. You have 3 over 4 instead. 15 divided by 4 and then times 3. So you have 15 over 4 and then times 3. I-multiply lang natin yan. So 15 times 3, that is 45 over 4. So you're going to be left with 11 and 1/4 days. It'll take them 11 and 1/4 or 11 and a quarter days to build the house. And again, kung i-compare mo, it makes sense na. Bakit? Kasi kung yung 9 people take 15 days, kung dadagdagan mo yung trabahante, mas bibilis silang magtatrabaho, it will take them less time or less number of days para matapos yung bahay. And that makes sense here. Kasi 11 and 1/4 is less than 15. Okay, now why am I teaching you this and why am I trying to teach you this as soon as possible? Kasi ang fear ko would be, kung dito lang kayo sa direct proportion familiar, paano kung ganito yung tanong na lumabas? Ano yung gagawin natin? So again, all you need to do, the difference is just if you flip mo siya. Instead of katapat ng 9 people yung 15 days, ilalagay mo siya sa ilalim and then yung x mo mapupunta sa taas kapag inverse yung proportion. Alright, so let's practice ha. Let's use another question. How about this one? Okay. Sabi, if 30 people can build a boat in 18 days, how long would it take 6 people to build one boat? So again, unang tanong, direct proportion ba siya or inverse proportion ba siya? In here, you have 13 people building a boat in 18 days. Hinahanap mo yung 6 people to build one boat. Okay? So in this case, ang tatanungin natin, okay, kung nagsimula ka sa 13 people, naging 6 people siya, okay? When they build a boat in 18 days, ang sagot ba dapat mas marami sa 18 or mas konti sa 18? So, syempre, kung nabawasan ka ng tao, it'll take more time, right, for them to build the boat. So, yung 13 people and then 6 people, kung itatapat ko kasi siya or gagawin ko siyang direct proportion, ang ibig sabihin nun, kung dito ko ilalagay yung 18, okay, it'll take, ang answer magiging lower than 18. Pero ang hinahanap natin dapat more than 18 kasi babagal sila eh. Kung babagal sila, the answer has to be more than 18. Kabaliktaran ng relationship. This is an inverse proportion. So, ang mangyayari, yung 18, instead na dito ko lalagay sa katapat niya, na which is 13 people, ibabagsak ko siya, lalagay ko siya dito sa ilalim. Dito ko ilalagay yung 18 days. And then I'm going to solve. Okay? So, again, this will be your x. Ikot lang natin siya. 18 divided by 6, that is 3. Times 13, that would be 39 days. Okay? So, again, it makes sense kasi kung nagbawas ka ng trabahante, syempre, mas matagal nilang tatrabahuin yung isang work. So, yung 18 magiging 39. So, mas more than 18 siya. The answer is 39 days. Okay? So, again, 2 steps. 1, analyze. Direct ba siya or inverse? And then, use the correct ratio. Kung inverse, babalik ta rin mo yung dapat katapat, hindi na siya ang magiging katapat niya. And then, you're going to do the exact same thing. Okay? Now, let's try another one. Okay. Here, ang question natin, sabi, if 4 pipes can fill a pool in 25 minutes, how long would it take 10 pipes to fill the same pool? So again, 4 pipes. Nagsimula ka sa 4 pipes. Dadamihan mo siya, magiging 10 pipes siya. So yung 25 minutes, dapat bibilis ka. What usually took you 25 minutes, ang mangyayari na lang would be less than 25 minutes. So this is an inverse proportion din. So 4 pipes, and then magiging 10 pipes siya. Yung 25, which is supposedly katapat ng 4, dahil ang sagot has to be less than 25, ilalagay mo siya sa ilalim. So, dito may pupunta yung 25 minutes. And then, ito ang magiging x. Kasi nga, inverse proportion siya. Now, if in case naman, di ba, ganun yung rule, tatanungin mo, pag dumami ba siya dadami rin, or pag dumami siya kukonti? Eh, syempre, pag dumami ang pipes, kukonti yung time, so babalik ta rin mo siya. Okay? And then, we're just going to use ratio rotation. So again, kung nahihirapan dito, lowest terms natin, this is 2 over 5. So we have 25 divided by 5, that is 5, times 2, the answer would be 10 minutes. And again, it will start to make sense. Bakit? Kasi kung 4 pipes lang ang bukas, 25 minutes eh. Siyempre kung dadagdagal ko yung pipes, bibilis yung pagpuno nila ng pool. So the answer has to be less than 25, which is going to be 10 minutes. Okay? So again, what I want you to understand here would be first, think kung ang tanong ba ay inverse or direct proportion, and then switch your position kung inverse siya, and then solve using ratio rotation, and then you have the correct answer. Okay? So, that's it muna for now. I will make a quick quiz video separate dito. So, if you want to catch that quiz, don't forget to hit subscribe and hit the bell icon para ma-notify kayo. Okay? That will be the next video that I post.
Alright, I hope you learned something new today. And if you did, click thumbs up. Make sure that you share this video with your friends. Sana pa mag-i-exam din sila para mas marami tayong matulungan. And as always, if you want to watch the next video na papunta, which is going to be the quick quiz related to this topic, don't forget to hit subscribe and hit the bell icon para malaman ninyo as soon as that new video posts. Thanks guys, and if you want to reach out to me directly, you can go to www.facebook.com/teamlyqa to find out how you can get the reviews that I made or if may mga upcoming review events that you can attend or join. Thank you guys, and as always, never stop learning. Kaya niyan, sabi ng t-shirt ko, adja adja, and I'll see you on my next video. Bye for now.